Oh, there?
Well, what do you expect, Doc? Even most of them have heads the size of a baseball. But there still is a lot we can learn about the past.
Who are those people over there, Lucy?
Good question, Tut. Those are Sumerians from the land of Mesopotamia. What you're looking at is pretty typical for 3000 BC. That guy's a famous Gilgamesh.
People, work with me now. We've got to work together.
Who do I make him king?
I heard that. Now I know you're all used to working independently and getting along just fine, but it's 110 degrees here, and this land is as dry as a desert.
Sir!
Yes, Enkidu, my valiant friend and servant?
It is a desert.
Okay, so it is a desert, but if we just work together a little bit, I think we can survive here and create one of the first great civilizations.
Hey, Gilgamesh is right, everybody. Working together, we can make sure that nobody messes with Mesopotamia.
Well put, Enkidu. Well put.
Thank you, sir.
Now we've got rivers on both sides of this point. And what are they called?
Rivers.
I know that, but what are the names of these rivers?
The Tigris and the Euphrates.
A plus. They've allowed our production of farm goods to go way up. So what's the problem?
The problem, sir, is that we need a more efficient way to transport these goods to market.
Right you are, Enkidu. Well, who's got a suggestion?
If I might suggest, I've been working on a small round intention that I think might have great possibilities.
I can't see it myself, but let's give it a try. Okay, what's next?
Well, sir, I've been working on a system of currency I think might help keep track of what we trade and what we owe.
A capital idea! Write it down!
Write it down, sir?
Figure it out, Enkidu. I can't do everything. I'm so proud of all of you. At this rate, we can create one of the first great civilizations right here between our own two beautiful rivers.
Seeds.
all still alive.
Alive? Well, we'll see about that. Listen up, here comes King Zelzer and his trusted servant, Imhotep.
Wow, they look pretty good considering we lived about 4,000 years ago.
King Zelzer, grain is scarce.
I've got no grain.
The fruit has all dried up.
Look at my fruit, it's completely dried up.
People are so desperate, they're robbing their neighbors.
Wow, look at that.
Die.
In my dreams, in my dreams.
Egypt dominated the earth for like 3,000 years.
Well, not the entire earth hockey, but they really were an amazing civilization.
But what could be more exciting than building pyramids?
Tut, tut, little tut. Very good question. But to help me answer it, let me introduce you to my good and very wise friend, Confucius.
Confucius says, hello, young and curious friends, for eras still to come.
Good afternoon, sir.
Confucius says, since you have asked, I must inform you that at the same moment that Egypt was flourishing, us in the East were creating dynasties of our own.
Does he always talk like that?
Confucius says,
I heard that. Confucius was a brilliant teacher some 2,500 years ago, and he's right. While Egypt flourished in the West, India and the dynasties of China were thriving in the East.
Confucius says, riches and honor are what everyone desires, but if they are gained by doing evil, they must not be held.
Nobody will believe you if you don't give it more emotion. Now please, one more time,
with feeling. One, two.
We are the chorus of the ancient Greeks. We all got together, so we practice for weeks. Listen very carefully, for when we speak, we'll tell you all the wonders of the ancient Greeks.
How's it going, Sophocles? Is the play almost finished? Terrible, just terrible, Herodias. The play in Athens is less than a week late, and can't get this chorus to get to work together for anything. Well, what's the play about anyway? It's supposed to be about all the wonderful things of Greece that'll be here thousands of years after we're dead and gone.
Sounds interesting.
It is interesting, but it can't come with the right style together.
How about the Odyssey?
No, I'm gonna keep you to it.
How about Greece the Musical?
It'll never fly.
How about Greece is a word?
What? What did you say?
Greece is a word, and give it a good chance.
That's it.
I just thought of it.
Legend says it all started with twin brothers and their dream to build a city. No, Romulus, I'm telling you, I had a dream, and in this dream, I saw six vultures flying over the exact spot where we should build the city.
No, Remus, I too had a dream. In my dream, I saw 12 vultures flying over the exact spot where they found the babies in that basket and raised by a wolf. 12 is more than 6, so that is where we should build the city.
6 is an omen from the gods. That's the spot I chose is right.
12 is a bigger one.
6.
12.
6.
12.
I'm telling Mom.
Oh, she cares. She's a wolf for Pete's sake. 9 is killing this rock. Now call it roll.
Hey, Romulus. How's that coming along?
Yeah, Romulus. Heard you having some problems with your aqueducts.
Hey, guys, it can't be built in a day, you know.
No need to be snippy, Romulus.
I just hope it's ready for Caesar to be bashed on Saturday night.
Oh, rats, I forgot about the big party. I don't even think of where.
Don't worry, Roman number one. The word is out. The white total. So you're all set.
Oh, that's great. I have a link on the cooler.
Well, what are we waiting for? Let's go.
Work.